We want to continue the conversation with Dr. Ben Weston, a medical director for the Milwaukee COVID-19 Emergency Operations Center. And Dr. Weston, it's great to speak with you again. Let's just start with 500,000 deaths here in the U.S. I'm curious, just if I were to ask you a year ago or even just 6 months ago, is this a number that you ever thought we would have reached here in the United States?
Yeah, thank you for having me back. It's nice to be here. I think a year ago, absolutely not. Even several months ago, I don't think so. Now, more recently, when we look at the trends showed that this was unfortunately a number we were going to get to around now. But it doesn't take away what a staggering number of deaths this is and what an incredible negative impact it's had on our country and the world.
Help us understand when you compare, for instance, where I'm at, New York City, with where I have a great many relatives, South Florida. South Florida, I think restaurants are 50% capacity. New York just went to 25% capacity. We had a more severe lockdown effort here. They didn't so much there, yet our numbers seem to be pretty much in line the same. So is that the argument to maybe loosen up the lockdown in New York City?
Yeah, you know, the regionality of COVID has been hard to interpret, to be honest. But it certainly does seem to have regionality. We saw the Northwest initially, and then the Southwest, and the Midwest, and the East, and it's jumped around. We are seeing sustained trends across the country now of decreased cases, decreased hospitalizations, and decreased deaths, which absolutely is good news. I think it shows that we're in a positive trajectory. Now, that is certainly threatened by the new strains that we're seeing. I think in particular, the B117 or UK strain definitely threatened that. So I think we are on a timeline. Can we vaccinate enough people and can we maintain our personal precautions to not see what the UK and other European countries saw, which is this enormous spike in cases and resulting hospitalizations and deaths from what we know is a more transmissible and what seems to be a deadlier strain of the virus.
Dr. Weston, you mentioned getting the population vaccinated as quickly as possible. Of course, there is this debate out there about whether or not we should be focusing on giving people their first shot or whether or not we should be focused on giving people the two doses that was initially recommended. Where do you stand on this? What do you think should be the approach right now?
Yeah, it's a complex question. I think that right now the science seems to indicate that it should be a two-dose vaccine. Now, that said, I think it certainly is worth exploring and revisiting the science at the CDC level, at the ACIP level, at the national level, revisiting that science and asking the question, is giving one dose for now, not long term, but for now, giving one dose and prolonging that second booster dose a little longer, is that an effective or perhaps a more effective strategy? I don't think we have the science to prove it right now, but I think it's worth looking back and reevaluating and seeing if that is a viable option.
Dr. Weston, real quick, you said a minute ago this UK variant seems to be deadlier. I think you're the first doctor to actually say that. We've asked about it. Usually we hear it's easier to catch, but they haven't committed to deadlier. What makes you say it's deadlier?
Well, so certainly easier to catch. There's evidence that it's up to 70% more transmissible. There has been some good evidence coming out of the UK that it does appear to be more severe. That's evidence that continues to need to be looked at, but it makes it concerning that it could be a more severe variant as well. But even the transmissibility alone makes it far more dangerous to our population, especially if we haven't ramped up vaccination to the extent that we want to.
Dr. Ben Weston, we always really appreciate you taking the time to join us here on Yahoo Finance, Medical Director for the Milwaukee COVID-19 Emergency Operations Center. We wish you and your team all the best.